The Mwini Mpaka-led select committee that investigated NSSF for close to a month, scrutinizing political scandals, has recommended resignation of the minister Betty Amongi in public interest after faulting the minister over her involvement in the initiation of the 6 billion budget, which she said was for popularizing the NSSF among savers. The minister had earlier told the committee that the money had been passed by the board, which they denied.
The actions of the minister are arbitrary and an abuse of office of the duty under the NSSF Act, thereby bringing her conduct within the ambit of the prohibition under Section 11 of the Anti-Corruption Act on abuse of office. The committee therefore recommends that the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Honourable Betty Amongi Ongom, resigns in public interest with immediate effect. We further recommend that the President should take keen interest in the Minister's conduct above.
The committee report also recommended that the NSSF board of the 7 members be dissolved over failure to occasionally secure the savers fund and provide effective management. As Parliament watched in surprise at the findings, the report indicated that former Managing Director Richard Biarugaba, Acting Caretaker and newly appointed Patrick Ayota, Chief Finance Officer Stephen Mwanje, and Corporate Affairs Manager Barbara Arimi Teddy step aside to pave way for the investigations by the IGG.
Prosecution recommends the prosecution of all officers and NSSF board members involved in the creation and transaction of Victoria Property Developments for causing financial loss of $2.05 million and abuse of office contrary to sections 20 and 11 of the Anti-Corruption Act 2009.
The ad hoc committee has also called for a lifestyle audit on Richard Biarugaba, Patrick Ayota and other 10 top management officials over involvement in corruption and other activities that undermine the management of the fund, causing losses to the savers.
That the IGG should conduct a lifestyle audit on the former managing director, Mr. Richard Biarugaba, the acting managing director, Mr. Ayota Patrick, the chief investment officer, Mr. Gerard Paul Kasato, the chief commercial officer, Mr. Geoffrey Sajabi, technology and enterprise solutions, Mr. Benon Katende, chief people and culture officer, Mr. Milton Owor, chief risk officer, Mr. Edward Senyonjo, head internal audit, Mr. Geoffrey Barije, head finance, Mr. Stephen Mwanje, head of marketing, head procurement, Mr. Gerard Mugabe, corporate affairs, Ms. Barbara Arimi, and report back to Parliament within 60 days of adoption of this report, because they are all part of management that has been approving all these projects you read that have caused financial loss.
The committee discovered several issues of mismanagement of public funds, abuse of office, cause of loss to savers' money, among others, and recommended as follows. However, debate on the report by members of Parliament has been stayed up to tomorrow, when the minister and other implicated legislators are expected to defend themselves.
I have a Minister of Gender, Minister of Finance, I have my members of Parliament. All of them will make statements tomorrow. The members of Parliament who have been mentioned in the report.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.